Jurisdiction, Part 3, Sandigan Bayan. If you go to the website of the Sandigan Bayan, there is a statement there that the jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan is perhaps one of the most often amended provision. Bakit? Kasi kahit kayo, makikita nyo na ilang beses itong inamend, binago ang jurisdiction ng Sandigan Bayan. The latest amendment is Republic Act No. 10660. This took effect on April 16, 2015 during the time of Pinoy or President Aquino. Before we go to the jurisdiction, just take note that your Sandigan Bayan, that is Sandigan ha, with letter N sa dulo, Sandigan Bayan is a special court. That is a special court and it is of the same level as the Court of Appeals. So, meron bang exclusive original jurisdiction si Sandigan Bayan? Exclusive na? Original pa? Answer is yes, merong exclusive original jurisdiction ang Sandigan Bayan. That is very clear according to Section 4 of PD 1606. But take note that this Section 4 was again amended according to Section 2 of RA 10660. So ano yung exclusive original jurisdiction ng Sandigan Bayan? Let's start with number 1, if there is a violation of what law? Republic Act number 3019. Ano ba yung Republic Act number 3019? That is the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. What else? If there is a violation of Republic Act number 1379, again, what is this RA number 1379? This is forfeiture of illegally acquired wealth. And last is if there is a violation of the Book 2 of the RPC, that is Title 7. Ang Title 7 is crimes committed by public officers. And then you're referring to Chapter 2. Chapter 2 is about malfeasance and misfeasance in office. Section 2 is about bribery, particularly direct bribery, indirect bribery, qualified bribery, and corruption of public officials. So this is our letter A. So aside from determining the nature of the offense, then you have to ask yourself, who is the accused? Because ang kailangan lang na requirement is one of the accused or two or more of the accused is an officer of the government holding a position either in a permanent capacity, acting capacity, or interim capacity. And at the time of the commission of the offense, he is a public officer. So take note ha, you have to determine the nature of the offense violated and then the accused. The accused must be a public officer. But do not stop there. Bakit? Because you determine where is the accused working and what is his salary grade. So, he could be a public officer working in the executive branch of the government, meaning he is an official of the executive branch occupying the positions of regional director and even higher. But you have to make sure that his salary grade is salary grade 27. Or that public officer is a member of a Congress or an official of a Congress or an officer of the Congress. Therefore, he is working in the legislative branch of the government, but make sure that his salary grade is salary grade 27, or he is a member of the judiciary, or he is a chairman and member of the CONCOM, that is your constitutional commissions, or he is a national officer or local officer, as long as his salary grade is salary grade 27. So balikan natin si executive. So if the accused is an officer working in the executive branch of the government, we said that you have to make sure that his salary grade is salary grade 27 for the Sandigan Bayan to acquire jurisdiction. But please, huwag kayong mag-stop sa salary grade. Kasi pwede ring i-determine kung papasok ang jurisdiction ng Sandigan Bayan through the possessions. What do I mean by that? You check if the accused is one working in the province or one working in the city. Because if his position is a provincial governor, if he is working in the province, vice governor, or member of the Sangguniang Panlalawigan, or if he is in the city, he is the city mayor, the vice mayor, or a member of the Sangguniang Panglungsod, then sino ang may jurisdiction automatic, do not determine the salary grade automatic kay Sandigan Bayan. Sino pa? Sa province, if he is the provincial treasurer, provincial assessor, or the provincial engineer, ang equivalent niyan, if you are in the city, is you are the city treasurer, city assessor, or the city engineer, and other provincial department heads, or if you are a city department heads, again, Sandigan Bayan has jurisdiction. Ano pa ang mga positions na kailangan mong matandaan? If you are working in the DFA, if you are a diplomat, so if your position is a consul and even higher, then again, si Sandigan Bayan ang may jurisdiction. Those working in the AFP, your position is Philippine Army and Air Force Colonel, Naval Captain, or other officers of higher rank. Those in the PNP, your position must be that one of a provincial director or your rank is senior superintendent and higher. Next is prosecutor. If you are working in the Department of Justice, you are the city prosecutor or the provincial prosecutor, or you are an assistant city prosecutor, then Sandigan Bayan has jurisdiction over you. At hindi ka lang mag-i-stop dun sa mga prosecutors na nagtatrabaho sa DOJ. Include also the prosecutors working in the office of the ombudsman, the special prosecutors, the officers in the office of the ombudsman. Sino pa? You have those working in the GOCCs and state universities. So these are your presidents, the directors or trustees, the managers working in the government-owned or controlled corporations, state universities or educational institutions or foundations. So dalawa ha, pagdating sa executive branch, titingnan mo kung pasok siya sa salary grade 27. Kung hindi siya pasok, titingnan mo ngayon kung ano ang kanyang positions. Pasok ba siya sa mga naka-enumerate na positions? Therefore, Sandigan Bayan has jurisdiction. Ano pa ang exclusive original jurisdiction ng Sandigan Bayan? You have letter B, other offenses or felonies, whether that is a simple offense or a complex offense with other crimes committed by the public officials and employees mentioned in what we have already stated in relation to their office. 1997 bar exam question, where is the proper venue if you want to file an information for a case of malversation of public funds by a Philippine consul detailed in the Philippine Embassy in London? So, what is the nature of the offense involved? That is malversation. And who is our accused? He is a consul. So, sino ang may jurisdiction? Answer is Sandigan Bayan. So ano pa ang exclusive original jurisdiction ng Sandigan Bayan? You have the civil cases as well as the criminal cases filed pursuant to and in connection with EO order or executive order number 1. Ano ba yung executive order number 1? That is your PCGG. Executive order number 2 is about the money, assets, and properties illegally acquired or misappropriated by the Marcoses, their close relatives, subordinates, business associates, dummies, agents, or nominees. Executive order number 14 is still about the ill-gotten wealth of the Marcoses, and executive order number 14-A, it amended executive order number 14. What else? Meron ding exclusive original jurisdiction si Sandigan Bayan over petitions for the issuance of your Rule 65, that is your CPM, certiorari, prohibition, and mandamus. Also include habeas corpus, injunctions, co-waranto, ano ang kailangang requirement? This is in aid of its appellate jurisdiction. 2009 bar exam question, true or false? Answer true if the statement is true, or false if the statement is false. You take note of the instruction, ha? Matindi ang instruction dito. You explain your answer in not more than 2 sentences. So, letter C, in the exercise of its original jurisdiction, the Sandigan Bayan may grant petitions for the issuance of a writ of habeas corpus. So, is it true or false? Answer is false. Bakit naging false? Kasi hindi in the exercise of its original jurisdiction. The Sandigan Bayan can grant petitions for habeas corpus only in aid of its appellate jurisdiction. Another bar exam question, MCQ, the Sandigan Bayan can entertain a co-waranto petition only in letter A, in cases involving public officers with salary grade 27 or higher, only in aid of its appellate jurisdiction as a provisional remedy, cases involving ill-gotten wealth. So the answer here is letter B, only in aid of its appellate jurisdiction. Let's emphasize again that the Sandigan Bayan has that exclusive original jurisdiction to issue writs of CPM, habeas corpus, injunctions, co-waranto. But it is not in its original jurisdiction. Take note, ha? Only in aid of its appellate jurisdiction. Ipasok natin sa discussion si Republic Act number 9160, that is your money laundering. Sino ang may jurisdiction? Answer is either RTC or Sandigan Bayan. RTC shall have jurisdiction to try all cases on money laundering, but if the accused is a public officer and there is a private person but he is in conspiracy with a public officer, then ang may jurisdiction is Sandigan Bayan. Question, can a private individual, meaning to say he is a private person, he is a person not working in the government, he is not a public officer, can you file a case against that private person in the Sandigan Bayan? Answer is yes. That is very clear according to your Section 4 of PD 1606. Ano ang condition? That private individual is a co-principal, or he is an accomplice or an accessory of the public officer or employee. And what will happen? That private individual together with the public officer or employee, they shall be tried in the Sandigan Bayan. Kaya take note, ha, pag maraming mga akusado, basta may isa lang na pasok sa Sandigan Bayan, whether his salary grade is salary grade 27 or he belongs to the positions that we mentioned, then kahit isa lang yan at marami silang akusado, yan ay papasok sa Sandigan Bayan. Another scenario, our accused committed the crimes that we already mentioned and he is also a public officer, but his salary grade is not salary grade 27. In that case, sino ang may jurisdiction? Answer is RTC or MTC. Ipapasok muna ngayon yung BP 129 to determine which among this court or which between this court has jurisdiction. So, ano pa ang merong jurisdiction si RTC aside from what we have mentioned? MTC or RTC has jurisdiction as long as the salary grade of the public officer is below salary grade 27. What else? RTC has exclusive original jurisdiction if yung information na ifa-file does not allege any damage to the government or it does not allege bribery. Or even if that information alleges damage to the government or if that information alleges bribery but the amount does not exceed 1 million pesos, then RTC again has exclusive original jurisdiction. How about the venue? Take note ha, yung venue in this case will be or shall be tried in a judicial region other than where the public officer holds office. So, yung venue is iba dun sa place kung saan nagtatrabaho si public officer. Take note of this kasi marami ang nadidismisan ng kaso because of this technicality. We'll go now to the appellate jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan. So, as far as the appellate jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan, take note that the final judgments or the resolutions issued or orders issued by the RTC, and the RTC here is exercising in its original jurisdiction, then where do you go next? You go to Sandigan Bayan. But if it is the RTC exercising its appellate jurisdiction, meaning to say the case came from MTC, inappeal mo sa RTC, therefore the RTC's decision is in the exercise of its appellate jurisdiction, then where do you go next? Again, you go to Sandigan Bayan. How about the concurrent jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan? Recall this slide. So as far as Sandigan Bayan is concerned, take note that meron lang concurrent jurisdiction ang Sandigan Bayan with the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeals, and the Regional Trial Court when it comes to the issuance of the writ of habeas data, that is your letter H, and the writ of amparo. So, take note ha, HA only, ha!